All right. So hello, everybody. Welcome to our Team Fit and Natural call. It's Wednesday, March 2nd, and I'm very excited to have Abby Walsh joining us tonight as our guest speaker. But before I get over to Abby, I just want to make a couple of quick announcement reminders. If you do want to sign up for Coach Basics, or if you have any coaches that want to sign up for Coach Basics or take it as a refresher, it starts on Monday. The sign-up post is up in our team group, so make sure you get on that. Also, AMP training starts Monday. I know that we have at least two applicants from our team, Bonnie and Renee, which is really awesome. If anybody else is Emerald and has completed Coach Basics and hit Success Club in the month of February, then please contact me ASAP to get the application for the training. And let's see, how many people ordered hammer and chisel already? Raise your hand if you've ordered. I got the deluxe kit, which I am super excited about. So I hope if you haven't ordered, you'll be ordering soon. You know, you want to be a model in this program. You want to share your journey. Remember in my team group, at least I shared a video from Liz Hartke, which gave her best advice for being, you know, kind of like a superstar coach. And it was that you take any program, you don't need to be in a test group, you take any program, you commit to it, you take your before pictures, you take your measurements, you publicly put it out there, I am doing this program, this is what I'm doing, you stick to it exactly the way the program was written, you follow it all the way along, and you share your journey the whole way, and then you share the results at the end. And that is the most powerful tool that you have as a coach. And we all have the opportunity to do that with 22-minute hardcore. So I hope to see many of you doing that. And I don't want to do too much for announcements. I want to go over to Abby, and I just want to tell you a little bit about her. She is a fellow 5-star diamond elite coach. She is from Pennsylvania. And we are in a Northeast Masterminds group together, and it's been awesome to connect with her. I've gotten so many great ideas and so many insights from her so far, and I'm really excited to learn from her tonight about what she's doing with email marketing and MailChimp and her like page and how those pieces kind of work together. So she is a mom, she is a nutritionist, has her degree in nutrition. She's also a gym owner. So she is a health extraordinaire, and I am going to let her start talking. Are you going to share your screen, Abby, or are you going to just...
I'm going to share my screen.
Okay, go ahead.
Awesome. Let me get my screen up here for you guys first. Somebody give me a nod that you can see that.
Yep.
Good, awesome. So thank you so much, Charisse. You know, she told you a little bit about me, but I want to give you guys just a little bit more background about myself before I get started so you feel like you know me better. I always feel like I can connect to people when I know them just a little bit. So, like she said, I am a mom and I'm a nutritionist and a gym owner, and I've got this crazy life that I never thought would be mine, but I love every moment of it. So, just a little bit of background on me. I actually am one of those people that signed up to be a coach off beachbody.com. Okay, I did not have an upline that I signed up under, and I tell you this because maybe some of you have got leads before and you maybe didn't reach out to them, or maybe they didn't reach back out to you when you contacted them, or maybe you're like, Abby, I don't even know what a customer lead is or a coach lead, but you know, you have to be at least an Emerald coach to get these, so make sure you hit Emerald if you're not there yet. That's one of the many benefits of being an Emerald coach, is being able to participate in the lead program. But if you hit Diamond, you actually get to participate in a program called the Coach Connection Program. And that is where my coach received me as a coach, was through the Coach Connection Program for her being a Diamond coach. And I just signed up to be a coach on Beachbody.com. I did that because I actually had clients at my gym asking me questions about all the different types of supplements on the market. Abby, what about this and that and what you can buy at GNC and all these other, you know, direct marketing products that people sell, are these good things for me? And I was like, I'm not going to lie to you, I don't know anything about these products. So I went out and I searched them out. I did my research and my homework, and most of them were so easy to just throw in the trash can and be like, these are junk. Like, I can't believe people are paying for these to put in their body. And I was like, no, you can't do that. No, you can't pop pills. That's an overpriced protein shake. And then Shakeology got a second look. And I was like, if this is half of what I am researching and finding out about it, this is something I'd actually tell people they could drink. So I did my homework. I was like, I think I'm going to try this and see if I think it's anything worthwhile, because I'm not going to tell somebody to try something I haven't tried. So I ordered a bag of Shakeology, and I'm pretty frugal. So I went and I read everything on the website, and I was like, I think it's cheaper to be a coach, whatever that is. So I just signed up, never trying Shakeology, never doing anything, as a coach solely for the discount. And when my coach called me and asked me, you know, hey, did you sign up to be a coach? And I was like, yeah, but sorry, I own a gym. I'm getting my master's in nutrition. I was in grad school at that time. And I was like, I have no interest in doing this whole coach thing. I'm like a real fitness professional. And I remember saying that to her and her being like, you just don't get it yet, you know? And she kept up with me, and I got my feet a little bit more into the business as I fell in love with Shakeology and just naturally started telling people about it. And then over time, it was actually when the 21 Day Fix came out, I fell in love head over heels with Beachbody, because I saw that there was a nutrition program that made healthy eating simple for people, that was something they could sustain forever, and was, in my opinion, the best nutrition plan anybody could ever make. So that's when me and Beachbody became best friends, and I started pursuing this as a business. And like Sheree said, you know, I was 5-star elite last year to end the year. And just so you all know, I was a diamond coach at the beginning of the year. I didn't hit 1-star until May of 2015, and I built 5-star. So anything's possible. So even if you're not a diamond coach at this time, know that the time that you decide to draw a line in the sand and say, I'm going to work this, you can make anything happen. All right. So that's a little bit of background on me, how I got into all of this. But, you know, I also, little side notes, my bachelor's is in dental hygiene. Like, I've had like a million jobs, and Beachbody allowed me to leave dental hygiene and pursue fitness and nutrition full time, which has been amazing. But one of the things that I need to do, because I have a very busy schedule, I still run and manage my gym, and I teach group fitness classes there as well. I see clients one-on-one for nutrition, and I'm a mom, and I've got a crazy schedule. I have to automate things in my life, and I have to have ways to keep track of people, and I have to have ways to email people in masses, and I have to have ways to give people some free value without spending a ton of time outside doing it. And what I want to share with you is that what I'm going to share with you tonight is free, okay? So you don't have to pay anything extra to enjoy this. You can do this for free right now in your business. So that's what we're going to talk about tonight, is expanding your market with email, and particularly MailChimp, because that's a free resource that you can use at any level in this business and create some amazing content for people. So here we go. So what I want you to think about right now is, what free value can you offer people? And if you're shaking your head and thinking, Abby, I'm not a fitness professional, I don't have a degree in nutrition, what do I have to offer people? I actually want you to think about the nutrition now. I want you to think about you and your unique self and what you have to offer people. All right. So I want you to start getting your brain churning as we talk through some of these things. And my screen is hidden with you guys, so I might not be able to read all my words. But basically, I want you to think about something that seems so basic to you, because you know so much about it that you wouldn't even think somebody would want that. All right. That's the kind of easy I want you to think about right now. What is something special that you can offer people in exchange for their email address? What mistakes do you see people making all the time that you wish you could just show them a better way? Whether it's a better way of straightening their hair or a better way of, you know, putting their makeup on, it doesn't matter. I just want you to think about something that you notice people doing that you could offer them a better way. What three basic tips could you give someone in life? What's something that drives you crazy that other people do or that they don't know how to do because it seems so basic for you? What do you do really well? What do people come and ask you for? All right, these are the things I want you to start thinking about and churning in your mind when you're thinking, what free value can I offer someone? So when you're learning how do you like to learn? Do you like to read things? Do you like to see things? Do you like to watch things? That's what I want you to think about right now, because the main thing in this business, especially when we're talking about freemiums, and we're talking about email, is attraction marketing. And I want you to attract people to you that are most like you. So those are people that learn like you. Those are people that like things that you like. So think about how you like to learn. Do you like to watch a video? Do you like to see things in picture form? Do you like to read text? How do you like to learn? These are all going to be things that compile what your freemium is like. So things to consider. It should be short. It should be informative. It should be helpful. It should almost feel like you're giving away too much for free. Like it's of such value to people that you're like, I could probably charge for that, but you're going to give it to them for free. But you want to make people want more. And that's the key. We don't want to get it all out there. We want to find that perfect point where it's just enough that this was helpful, but people want more from you. Okay. So the most popular forms of freemiums, and if you don't know what a freemium is, let's just be real. It's a made up word. All right. First, it's just something we're giving people for free in exchange for their email address. So think about it that way and everything that we talk about. So the most popular forms of freemiums are videos, written things, which could be like a PDF or an ebook or a document, a list, or a webinar. All right. So here is a picture of my freemium. My freemium is actually an ongoing thing, and it's a weekly email. Let me just stop. Everybody stop writing. Look at me in the eyes. Do not do something weekly. This was the biggest mistake I made, all right? But I love what I do, and I offer it to people. But don't commit yourself to something every week like that. Make it like a one-time thing or a once-a-month newsletter or something like that. Don't hook yourself on doing something every week for people. But mine's a weekly recipe email. This isn't that big of a deal for me because I love to cook and I love to design recipes. I love to come up with new recipes. So it's not that much work for me, but it is tedious sending out something every week to people. So what I do, this is a picture of mine. It's a recipe, usually a recipe that I made that week, and I send it out. And what I do is I just add a little bit of, hey, here's a little bit more information about what I do in that email. So there's always in my emails, the recipe container count for the 21-day fix. So that people who are doing the 21-day fix are benefiting, but also people who are like, what is the 21-day fix? That looks kind of cool. If they click on that, it's going to email me, and I'm going to get to talk to them about their goals. All right, so that's just a picture of mine to put in your mind as we talk through here. So I'm going to show you MailChimp, all right? MailChimp is just MailChimp.com. If you don't know that, you're going to create a free account, and it's easy. You can link it to your Facebook, or you can just make one up. It doesn't matter. And you do it with whatever email you want to use. So mine's with the Gmail account that I use for Beachbody stuff. So all you do when you're going to go in here is you're going to click, and you're going to be on your dashboard, and I drew arrows for you, and I can give Charisse these slides afterwards too so that you guys don't have to write everything down. But basically, you click on campaigns, and we create a campaign. I always make a regular campaign, but as you get better at this, you can do other things with it as well. But the most simple thing to do is a regular campaign, which allows you to do all text, text, pictures, and videos, all of that, but it's just tracking who opens it and how many times they clicked on things, basically. So we're going to create a campaign. You're going to click on your list, all right? Your list will be appeared there when it asks you that question. I'm showing you this when I made this this presentation for my team. It was after I started my recipe email for 4 weeks. So my list went from zero to 218 people, from people just choosing to opt in on their own within a 4 week period. This wasn't me adding customers of mine to a list or adding anybody. These were people that chose to opt in through an opt-in link that I'm going to show you in a few minutes. So that's just to show you how this can really grow and be something that you're giving more and more people. Like now this was the sixth week I put out my recipe email, and I think it was up to 270 people now that I'm sending an email out to every week. That's 270 people that I can send any email out to I want, not just my recipe email, which is what we'll get to in a minute. So you're going to choose the list that you'd want to send it to. And then we're just going to do some info on our campaign. These are the screens that you'll see when you do this on your MailChimp. You'll name your campaign. That's not important. Like mine's usually like Tasty Tuesday email number 6, you know, whatever one I'm doing. Nobody's going to see that. Your email subject is what they're going to see. And that's what's important. You want to think about something catchy. What's going to make people open that email? I usually write something funny. Like this week I sent out that lemon basil salmon. It was the week of Valentine's Day. I wanted a fancier meal for people in case they wanted to eat at home. And, you know, I wrote the lyrics to Fancy, the Iggy song, like in there about being fancy cooking. You know, like I think of something funny and catchy to put in my email subject line. And then that's just who it's from in my email. It's going to ask you to pick a template that you want to work from. You can use any of these. I'll show you some different ones in a few minutes. But basically, you know, there's different things that are good for different things. If you're going to write out like a newsletter kind of thing, maybe you want some of the ones in the second row that have multiple pictures and text area that you can plug into. Or if you're sending out a video, you'd want one of those ones with just a big block that we could put your video in. All right. But what I do is usually one of those big blocks. I usually pick that first one that says good for large images there that I wrote, and then I create my template and I save it. So then I drew an arrow there for you to see that save template. So if I was creating Tasty Tuesday number 7, I would click on save templates because I've already created one and I just swap out my picture each week. Okay, so that's just to give you some tips of what you can do. But you pick your template that you want to use and you design it. This is what it looks like. It's just drag and drop. It's so simple. You drag and drop your picture, you browse and find it on your computer, you type in the text, and you see all those things on the right there. You can put in your social networks. You can do that like social share and follow buttons. And then I linked all those to my pages and you just click on each one individually and you type in your Facebook profile link. You type in your email link, you type in your blog or website if you have that. But any of those things work. Then say you were doing a video, you just click that video button and you plug in your YouTube link from what you uploaded onto YouTube and it would embed that into your email for you. Okay, it's super simple to use. So there you go. So then say you design this right up at the top, I drew that arrow for you, you could save it as a template there. So in the future you can come back and maybe you're going to swap out a video for something else you made for a different freemium. You already have a baseline for your template. Okay. Does that make sense? Cool. All right. Moving on. Squirrel moment for you guys. You'll learn this about me quickly. I love to just go off track. So I just programmed an off-track moment for myself to tell you something right now. So here's my squirrel moment for you. I use MailChimp for so many things in my business outside of a freemium, okay? I use this to send out newsletters to my challengers and to all my customers in my database. Around the holidays, I sent out a thing about gingerbread protein pancakes and, you know, a workout they could do that was winter-related. I send out video tips to my challengers via email. Other things I do with it is I'll send out big campaigns. Maybe some of you guys don't know this, but in your back office, you can actually search through an advanced customer search and see everybody that's ever purchased whatever from you. So I searched everybody that's ever purchased 21 Day Fix from me, and I went through and created a campaign just for them, and I asked them, like, my tagline was, did your dog eat your containers? You know, where are your containers at? Are they dusty on a bookshelf? Did you ever finish the program? What's going on? And this was like a revive challenge group I did for anybody who had purchased 21 Day Fix from me. So there's different ways that you can campaign and pull those lists, put them into MailChimp, and mass email out all those people at the same time. I also do a weekly coach check-in for all my coaches. I send them this email that says what we're doing, any important dates for the week. And I do that all through MailChimp. So there's lots of things you can use MailChimp for, and it's all free, which is awesome. Don't we love free things? I love free things. So that's my squirrel moment. Let's get back on track. I just want you to know that you're learning a tool that you can use for so many other things. So embrace it. So here we are. Now we're in here. How do we build a list, right? So I told you that my freemium list started with 0 people. And how I did this was I just went to lists in MailChimp and I created a list. For this one, I picked freemium example as just the example for this. But mine was Tasty Tuesday email list, all right? Now, when you do this, it says you have 0 subscribers, and then look at the arrow at the bottom. It says create sign up form. All right, that's what I want you guys to do. You're going to create a sign up form for people to choose to be on this email list for you. All right, now we're going to do this first form, the general form. This just creates a simple link. As you get more into this, say you have a website, you could create a pop-up for your website that when somebody signed on your website, it would pop up and say, would you like to subscribe to my Tasty Tuesday email? There's different ones you can make, but the one I'm going to show you is just a general link, all right? So we're going to create a simple link by doing the general forms, And this is what's going to happen. So on the right there, I'm showing you what mine looks like. You can customize it and make it look pretty with adding a picture. It just starts with like a gray background, and those are the simple forms. You can add all those fields. You'll see in the top left picture on the right side, it says like text, number, radio buttons, check boxes, all that stuff. I would recommend only using email, first name, last name. People don't like to be bothered. All right, this, you could create a form with this basically, you know, just like WooFoo and all that if you wanted to. But for this purpose of creating like an opt-in for an email, people want to take the least amount of time possible to complete a task. So first name, last name, email is all you need. But I'd encourage you to make a cute graphic for the top. You know, you can insert a cover photo in there. That size works really well. Mine was a banner I made for something else that fit on there fine too. But if you guys don't know, I made mine on Canva.com. That's also a free source that you can use. You can make beautiful cover photos on there really simply. So that's all I did was plug in my image, and then that's it. I wrote my little tagline there where it says click to add message. Moving on. So now it's going to show you a link. That's the link to your form, your opt-in form for your list. All you have to do is copy that and paste it anywhere you want. And I'm going to show you a couple places to paste it to get people to opt in. So if you guys don't know what this whole opt-in concept means, basically when somebody would click that link, wherever it is, it would pop up that form I just showed you. Mine's down there that says, welcome, please subscribe here. All right. And then once they do that, their name is automatically added to your list in MailChimp. You don't have to do anything. They're automatically on that list. So then when you go in to send your campaign out, you send it to everybody on that list and it's already done for you. Okay. Does that make sense? Cool. So you have their sign up form. You have the link. Now, what do we do with it? I'm going to show you where I put mine. So on my like page, do a lot of you have like pages on Facebook? Yeah. If you have a like page on Facebook, there is a button there that you can edit. All right. Right now yours will say, if you haven't had anything there, it'll say create call to action. All right, you would click that button and it gives you a drop down that you can choose what you want it to be. So I picked sign up. Now, if somebody clicks that sign up button, it gives you an option to put a website in there. I put in my link to my form. All right, so that link that we just copied and pasted from the slide before, we're gonna put that in that box where it says website. So now when somebody clicks the sign up form on my like page, this is what they get. They get that please subscribe here box for my Tasty Tuesday email. Okay, does that make sense? Cool, and that's free. I didn't have to pay for that. And I get so many people that sign up there. I also put it in just the description of my cover photo. So if somebody clicks on my like page and they see welcome, click to subscribe, maybe they don't know to click sign up. We want it to be in as many places as possible. So if they just click on my cover photo, in the photo description there, I included the link there as well and wrote a little message. I can show that to you guys after if you want to see it. But that's where I put it. So then people can sign up right there. What are other things I do? So if you don't know, you can do this too. This is also free on a like page. You can click right where your status is. You can click create offer. And when you pick offer, you can put in an online redemption link code right there, and you could put that same link from your opt-in there for people to opt in to your freemium. So here's an example of my offer. I just put a picture of one of my meals, and I wrote free weekly recipe email. I uploaded that image. I picked an expiration date. That doesn't even matter because I'll send this out. You know, it's not expiring. But, you know, you pick an expiration date so it ends. And you can say there's no limit to how many people are going to buy that from you because it's free and it starts now. And then you put in your redemption link. Okay. So that's another way you can do it. Now, I'll also tell you from there. So that will post to your like page then. Usually if something says free on it, it does really well on your like page without paying anything, right? People are sharing stuff. They're like, oh my gosh, free stuff. Yay. But what you can do is you can also boost that post if you want. So something to think about when you're making your offer is if you want to boost it, which is a paid feature on Facebook, you can choose the amount of money you want to boost it for. If you're going to boost it, you only want 20% of it to be text or Facebook won't approve it. So make sure that you have more picture than text if you want to be able to boost it. But that's totally up to you. So moving on. jab, jab, hook, it still applies. So I wrote this on this for my team, but I'm going to go over this in case some of you don't know what that means. So jab, jab, hook is a concept that we use in social media posting, period. That means that we're giving, we're giving, we're giving, we're asking. Okay. So we're giving valuable content and then we're going to ask people for something in exchange eventually, right? Same thing goes for like on our Facebook when we're posting, we're, you know, just giving little breadcrumbs of like, here's an amazing meal I ate tonight. P.S. It's 21 Day Fix approved. I didn't ask anybody to join my challenge group. I was just showing them how I eat in day-to-day life and that it works on my meal plan, all right? The same thing would apply if you were like, oh, I just bought this awesome straightener at the store. So glad I cannot have to worry about replacing my straightener because of my Beachbody income. You know, you're saying something about what you do and why you love it, but you're not asking people to do it. That's a jab. A hook is when I ask somebody to join me for something. So this still applies in how I'm emailing people. So I'm giving them free value, right? I'm giving them a recipe and I'm telling them how it applies on the 21 Day Fix. That's all free stuff. And I'm just teeny little jab. If people want to try it, like click here, but nothing crazy. So after like 2 weeks of sending out free emails, it was time that I was advertising for my challenge group. So then I also included how people could join my challenge group in my email. Okay. So it was my Project Love Yourself challenge. I explained the registration was open. And if they click on that photo, it would email me. And I have that set up in MailChimp. All you do for that is when you upload a picture, there's a little button that says link and you click that and you type in if you want it to link to a website or to an opt-in or if you want it to link to an email. And mine just says email. I type in my email and then I write a subject line. I'm like challenge group interest in the subject line. And when they email me to my email, it'll automatically say in the subject line challenge group interest. So I know that came from my ad. Does that make sense? Yeah. So we want to make sure that we're offering people free value, but we're still asking them for something, or otherwise we're just going to be doing things for free all the time and never getting anything. You know, something I just did now too, because I've been sending out these emails for 6 weeks now, 22 Hardcore came out. I sent an email to everybody I had on my list, not about recipes, but about 22 Minute Hardcore, because I've been giving them free value and now I'm asking them for something. So all I did for that was I just created, you know, a campaign in MailChimp, just like I did for my Tasty Tuesday email. I chose my email list to be my Tasty Tuesday list, but I wasn't sending out a Tasty Tuesday email this time. I was sending out an invitation to my challenge group. Does that make sense? Cool. Okay. So I'm going to stop sharing. Actually, do you guys want to see where I link that to my cover photo on Facebook? Does that make sense to you when I said just add it in the description? I can pull it up real quick and show you just in case you don't know what I'm talking about. So this is just literally my cover photo on my like page. When you click on whatever your cover photo is right now, it might take a minute to load. All right. When you click on your cover photo, once mine loads, it'll pop up. You could just click, I think mine's covering it, but there's a thing that says edit description. Do you see that on my page? You guys are covering up my stuff. Okay, cool. You just click edit description and you could type something in there. So I hit edit description after the fact and I type that in, you know, hey there, welcome to my page. Thanks for taking the time to follow my health journey. I hope to provide you with great value through recipes, inspiration, opportunity. Please be sure to click the like button on the page. Want my free recipe email? I'd love to send it your way. Just click this link to add your name to my email list. Okay. So that's just another place that I can put it. Something else that I didn't tell you guys is that, let me look through my photos. Maybe I'll see something I can show you. Basically, I put this link out all the time. So like, I'm trying to think, when was the last one I did? Was it on this one, maybe? No, it's not on this one. But basically, anytime I post like a picture of food, I'll often just put in, you know, that post, I'll say, hey, do you get my recipe email ? If you don't and you want to opt in, click the link in the first comment. And I'll put that link in the first comment of my post. So you can literally put this anywhere, anywhere you want to put it. All right. Does that make sense to everybody? Yeah. Cool. So that's my spiel on MailChimp and creating a freemium. I'd love to answer your questions. If you guys have questions specifically about creating a freemium, about, you know, MailChimp, about opt-in links, let me know and I'd love to answer them for you.
Abby, that was so awesome. Thank you. That was
beautiful
information. I have so many ideas running through my head about what I want to do with this. I have a quick question about, have you found any triggers for your emails landing in people's spam? Because I sometimes, when I'm working with email marketing, I find that not always does my first email go through. And then if I reply back to that email, then people will be like, oh, sorry, it was in my spam folder. But do you find certain words or different things get you in spam?
You know what I've found is that when people choose to opt into something, I usually don't go to their spam because they were looking for it, especially when they knew when it was coming. Like, people knew my email was going to come on Tuesday. So I got some messages from people. Hey, Abby, I didn't get your email, but I did subscribe. And so I told them, hey, put my email in your address book so that way I don't go to your spam next time. And that fixed it for most people. Also, whenever you try to opt in, I can't show you because it won't let me test my own link. But when you go to opt in, it'll say like, hey, you just got an email, verify your email. You can click there, add to address book right at that time. And then it always makes sure that people get your emails, which is great.
Okay, awesome.
And if they do that one time, like in the beginning, you're sending them free content. So why wouldn't they want to add you to their address book, you know? And then you're always going to go to their inbox, even when you're sending them maybe the things they didn't care as much about, okay. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
And guys, the other thing I do with mine is, you know, I also, I don't know if you guys do this or not, but I recommend running a free group every single month or a low pay group. You know, I either run a Shakeology tasting group or a free group every single month. And so I'm blast emailing these people. Hey, do you want to join my free 5-day clean eating group? Who isn't going to say yes to that, right? So then it's giving them another avenue to get free value from you. And I actually, you know, I've had two people join as coaches just through my emails from, you know, talking back and forth after that when they wanted more information. I just had a girl email me today about 22 hardcore just from that email I sent out. And, you know, so that's just one more avenue that you have to reach out to people that's totally different from what you're already doing now. It's a way to expand your market in a different way with little effort, really. And think about whatever you're doing, you can have as value to anybody, value to your challengers, value to your coaches, value to people that aren't even interested yet, but are prospects for you. So it can be something that's valuable to so many people.
Awesome.
Any questions?
Let's see. Kristen has a question. Go ahead, Kristen.
I do. I have a question, and it's not to be negative in any way. I'm just curious. What happens if somebody wants to opt out of your emails?
Yeah.
Is that something?
They can opt out at any time. So this is like, these are two things I'd recommend. So MailChimp automatically creates something in the bottom of every email that says, click here to unsubscribe. Like, people always have the opportunity to unsubscribe because it was an opt-in to begin with. Most times, if you do this right and you're like giving, 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 then asking, people don't opt out because they still see enough value in opting in, even if they're not interested at this time. But if you get somebody's email and then you never send them the free thing and you start just asking, then they're going to opt out automatically. Another kind of trick you can do is that instead of sending out an email from your free list of people. So like when I went to send out that 22 hardcore email, I took my Tasty Tuesday email list in MailChimp and I just clicked copy list and I created a new list that I sent out for 22 hardcore. So if anybody unsubscribed to that, they weren't unsubscribing from my Tasty Tuesday list. So I still have opportunity to keep in contact with them, if that makes sense. So you don't have to do that by any means. That's kind of a little trick.
That's a really good
But thing. If they click unsubscribe, does the program automatically unsubscribe them, or do you have to go in and do something?
No, it does it for you.
That's That's yep. what I was wanting.
When they click unsubscribe, they won't actually be deleted from your list, but you'll see that they're no longer checked to receive okay. your email. And what's cool too, I should actually pull that up and show you guys while we're talking about it. On MailChimp, the reason why I love MailChimp is that it shows you so much. So it'll tell you like, hey, after that campaign you sent out, 3 people unsubscribed, Kristen. Maybe you don't want to do that anymore. You know what I mean? So okay. it'll show you who unsubscribed also, so you can kind of reach out to them and be like, hey, you know, what's going on there? And they might be like, oh, I wasn't interested, you know, whatever. But it gives you an opportunity to talk to them, because what have we learned in coaching? When people aren't interested, it usually just means they have more questions. And so if you know that they unsubscribed, you have a chance to talk to them once again, because you still have their email. So that's what's good news there as well. So let me pull this up for you guys. Take 1 second to load. But I'll show you my dashboard on here just so you can see. All right, so this will show you like yesterday I sent out my email, and out of 237 people that it reached their inbox, 137 of them opened it. That's really good for email marketing to have over half your people open it. Usually, literally no more than 30% of people will open your emails, even if they opt into something. So that's a great result to see. It's also cool to see, it'll show you 2 people clicked. What that means is 2 people clicked on links or pictures outside of my email. So they clicked on maybe my 22 hardcore picture that asked them if they wanted to join my group, or they clicked on the link to my Facebook profile. It'll show you that and you can see it. You can also, if anybody unsubscribed, it would show me on here as well, which is cool. It also shows you like, okay, when are people subscribing more? And you can see different reports, and you could click on here to pick the different emails that you've sent out to see those for anything. Cool. Any other questions?
Jen has a question.
Sorry, I was just trying to unmute myself. Hi, that was great. Thank you very much. I actually have 2 questions, if you don't mind. I saw that on your dashboard, you could see how many people viewed it. Can you see which people viewed it?
You, let me click. I don't lie to you. Yes, when you click that button that says like 57% opened your email, it will actually show you those people here. Let me just hit share screen again so you can see it. I should have just kept it up for you. So like when I click that button that see who opened it, it will show me who opened it, what time they opened it, and how many times they opened it. Like this person opened my email twice. This person opened it 3 times. They're a little bit more interested. So that will show you also a lot of information about them.
Okay. And then to put the people into the list, can you link it to Gmail?
You mean so that your list goes to Gmail instead?
So that it would use my contacts from Gmail?
You want to import your contacts?
Yes.
From Gmail to MailChimp?
Can you do that?
Yeah. So, you know, when I showed you my screen that was like, you know, create list, and then it was like, you don't have anybody, pick the sign up form.
Okay.
There's a button right in the middle that says import, and you can just import a contact list. So, like, you could import your contact list from the back office if you wanted to, anybody that's ever ordered from you. You could import your coach list. You could import whatever you want to import.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Abby, I have another question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Can you schedule emails to go out on a certain schedule at certain times?
Yeah, you can schedule them. There's an automation feature that you could be like, I don't want to send this out right now. I want to send this out tomorrow at 8 p.m., you know, or whatever you want to do.
Okay.
I've never set up a recurring schedule for the same email, so I don't know that you could do that. But it has a lot of features, so I would assume that you probably could.
Okay. Okay, great. Anyone else?
Other little tips that you guys can, you know, just marinate on as you consider what type of freemium you may send out would be like, maybe you want to do something where once a month you're sending out the exact same thing. Maybe you're just creating one PDF or one video and you're sending that out, you know, and you don't want to send it out to the same people over again that already received it from you, each month you could create a separate opt-in link. So you could just go through that same process and you could name your opt-in link like February opt-in. And, you know, you could say that you send out this video on the first day of the month or whatever you want to say. People are getting something for free, so it doesn't really matter exactly that. But you could do something like that where you're like, okay, as soon as they opt in, I have a whole list. And then at one time I send it out to all those people. And then maybe you create a new list for the next month. Or maybe you want to stay on top of it at the beginning and you're like, okay, every week I'm going to send this out. You know, if you get to a point where you're like, this is really done well, you could look into a paid feature of a different site that would send something automatically as soon as somebody opts into it. But right now in your business, when you're just exploring this, I always like to offer people free options as coaches. We don't need to always invest more money than we're making. You know, let's try to find some things where we can save ourselves money at the same time. Does that make sense?
Yeah, cool. Absolutely.
Yeah, well, I hope this was helpful for you guys. If you have any questions, I'm happy to answer them. Charisse can throw them my way, and I can answer those for you. But, you know, I think, like, the best thing to tell you is I always say, like, I like to give people call to action. So, you know, think about what you can do as a freemium. This doesn't have to take you a lot of time to put together. You know, that's the type of freemium I want you to make, is something that you could literally sit down and make in a day. Because you don't have to do research on it. It's something that's just so simple for you. And if you're like, I really don't know what's the most like low maintenance freemium I could do, I would say a video. Literally like a video of your top three tips to do whatever, you know. And you write those down for yourself so you stay on track. And when we make videos with like three tips, we can usually stay on track really well and keep that video in like 2 minutes, 3 minutes tops. And people will be really prone to watch that kind of thing. So maybe you're going to send out something once a month with your, you know, top tips on whatever. Or maybe you're only going to send something out one time. But think about what you're going to do. And I challenge you all to let Charisse know by the end of the week what your freemium's going to be. And I challenge you to have a freemium by next week, literally. Like, that's how easy I want this to be for you, is just to get something free out there for people. It could be a one-page document. It could be, you know, let me pick on somebody, Danielle's top 10 meal planning tips, you know, and it could just be a one-page document that you send out to people. You know, think about something that you're already doing that's not hard, and send that out to people. People, you'd be so surprised how much people want for free, you know? And like, it could be something that somebody could easily Google, but nobody wants to Google it. If it's offered to them right in front of them right now for free, they're going to take it because people don't like effort. So, you know, think about ways that you can make people have an easier time doing something. It's that simple. And it's going to open the door for you to market to people in different ways. Cool. That's all I got to say.
That was so great. Thank you, Abby.
Oh, you're welcome.
I'm sure this leaves people with tons of food for thought about how they're going to get things going, because I don't think most people are doing anything with email, and this is going to go a long way for us. So thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. Have a great night, guys. Thanks so much for getting on.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good night, guys.
Uh-huh.
Bye. Bye.